welcome everybody to day one of the 2022 Reliance Foundation Junior MBA Coach Academy Online. It is the first time we've ever done this online, and it is great to see all of you coaches that have registered and joined tonight. I know it's a late night there, well, not too late. So thank you for joining, and helping grow the game of basketball across India. We're very thankful for everything that all of you coaches and PE teachers and administrators do already. And we are really excited to be with you all today. I'm gonna get, once again, just make sure we're giving enough time to get everybody in. Okay, before I introduce myself and the rest of the people we have from MBA India here, I do just want to go over just a couple rules that we'd like to have followed for all coaches on the call today. Number one, please try to keep yourself on mute. We don't want a lot of background noise as we go through this session. There will be plenty of opportunities for engagement, so we're going to be asking questions. And at that time, if you have an answer to the question, or even a thought on, you know, one of the drills that we show, you know, you can raise your hand with an emoji just like this, or you can actually physically raise your hand if you're on camera, okay? So if you do that, we will call on you, or we'll try to call on you, but we want this to be engaging. We just don't want a lot of background noise as we're going through the rest of the session, okay? And I see a lot of people saying good evening and hello on the chat. We love that. That's another great way for you guys all to, guys and girls, to all, you know, engage with us throughout this session. Okay. Now, I want to start on time, but I also want to make sure anyone who's having any technical difficulties has enough time to get in. All right. I see Baby Cootie on the call. My guy, Joseph Gomes from Calcutta. Coach Kevin, how you doing? Pavi from Delhi, how's it going? A lot of familiar names, familiar faces. It's great to see everybody. Now, you guys can also, you know, please turn on your cameras if you'd like as well. We'd love to put faces to names, especially if you have a thought or a question that's going to get answered. You know, please turn your camera on. We'd love to see you. Okay. So thank you to those who already have their camera on. Appreciate that. Okay, so I think that's good. We're at about 8:03. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so once again, I want to welcome everybody to day one of the 2022 RF Junior MBA Coach Academy Online. This is our first time ever doing this online. Usually we're on ground when we do these Coach Academies. Hopefully we'll be back on ground very soon. But for right now, we're here online together, helping to grow the game of basketball. My name is Coach Brian Gamra. I work for MBA India. But before, you know, we get into this session, I want to introduce the other people who are going to be helping me run this session today. First, we have Coach Scott Fleming, who many of you no doubt know. He's former head coach of the India men's national team and the current technical director for the NBA Academy in Delhi. I know a lot of you know him. So, Coach Scott, you want to go ahead and introduce yourself?
Yeah, namaste. Great to see all of you. I'm looking through the list, and a lot of the people I know are good friends of mine. And unfortunately, I'm still back in the U.S., but I think it's coming soon. Hopefully by next month, we're working toward getting me back in India. So, hey, this is going to be a great session. We're going to talk my favorite subject, basketball, and hopefully some of the things that you'll learn today will be, if not new to you, just great reminders. So, hey, thanks for everybody joining.
Absolutely. And next we have Shivaraj Kumar, who was the team manager at the NBA Academy in Delhi since it opened and has recently joined our basketball operations team at NBA India officially last year. And I know a lot of you know Shiv, so I want to go ahead and let Shiv introduce himself. Someone's already breaking the first rule.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for taking your time for joining first day one of the Coach Academy. You know, really excited. A lot of familiar faces and a lot of new ones to get connected with. We're happy to connect with each and everyone for the Coach Academy online. Thank you. We're looking forward to, like, you know, to see you all on ground soon. Thank you.
All right, now I just want to mention one more time, please keep yourself on mute.
Just, you know,
until we call on you. All right. Let's make sure we keep ourselves on mute. Finally, guys, my name is Coach Brian Gamroth. I'm the basketball operations lead for NBA India. And, you know, I've been working with NBA India now for about 2.5 years. Unfortunately, I'm still in the U.S. as well. I'm in New York right now, but should be back in India very, very soon as we look to start back with all of our on-ground programs from the junior NBA all the way through the NBA Academy. So it is great to see everybody. Now, together with Reliance Foundation, we are really proud to start off our junior NBA program for this year. And, you know, before we get into the program, I just want to take a moment to recognize our great partner who's been with us since the very beginning of the junior NBA program, way back in 2013. That's Reliance Foundation. So let's take a look at this video by Reliance Foundation. Reliance Foundation, our amazing partner with the RF Junior NBA program. Now, I want to know who all of you are. Okay, so this session, it's day one of our Coach Academy. This is for coaches, PE teachers, and basketball administrators all over India. Okay, so let's take, we're going to put up a poll here because I want to see where everyone's from. Okay, so we have coaches from all across India. So we put up 5 different regions. We've got north, northeast, east, west, and south. Okay. Oh, okay. We got a lot of answers coming in here. Looks like west is the early leader. We're going to give it about another 20 seconds here. We've got almost half of you participated. We really want to see where you all are from. So please get those answers in. Again, this session is day one. And I'll explain a lot more about what we're going to be doing today. But, you know, we have 2 days. Day one is a little bit more for the beginner players and coaches. And day two is going to be a little bit more advanced concepts. Okay, so let's see here. We had about 58 of you respond. And it looks like the East is leading. We got 19 coaches. 20 now. Okay, I'm going to give you 10 more seconds. 9, 8, 7. Okay, and that'll be the end of the poll right here. you didn't answer in time, you just missed out. Okay, let's see. Let's see if we. I'm going to share the results on the screen here. So we had East and South representing quite a bit, and the West, North, and Northeast coming in strong as well. So thank you to all of you who are joining. Again, this is great to see because this shows that we are all over the country growing the game of basketball together, which is all of our goals. Okay, great. Now, I would love to know how each one of you are coaching. Okay, so there's a couple different options. There's, you're coaching a team, you're coaching a club team, you're coaching a school team. Some of you may be PE teachers. So I have another poll question on the screen right now, and I want to know how you guys are coaching. School team, club team, PE teacher, administrator, or other. You might just be a basketball fan. Okay, and that's great too. And we're happy to have you on here. All right, let's see. And you know what? I also would love for you guys, if you can, put in the chat. If you're coaching at a club, what club do you coach? I would love to see in the chat. I want to know what some of the names that we have. Or if you're at a school, what school are you coaching at? I'm gonna give it a couple more minutes here. Okay, looks like we have a lot of PE teachers and a lot of school team coaches. That's great. Okay. Anybody want to let us know what club are you coaching? Please put that in the chat. Would love to see. I might just call on somebody. Let's see here. I see Rohan Bosale. Coach Rohan, your camera's on. I'm gonna take you off mute. What type of coach are you? Are you a PE teacher? Are you a basketball coach? Are you just wanting to grow the game?
Yeah, I wanted to grow the game. I'm a, like beginner in this coaching platform. I am a player from school level, and I am very much interested to be a coach going forward.
That's great. Well, coaches like you and people like you are the reason that basketball will grow. So thank you, Coach Rohan. Appreciate that.
Thank you, sir.
And it's awesome to see that. And I hope a lot more of you, who may not be coaches yet but want to be coaches, are also going to get something out of this. So thanks, Coach. We've got someone from Chandigarh Basketball Academy at St. Joseph's School. That's great. Okay, so I just wanted to just find out what everyone's coaching, and it looks like. Let me see the poll results here. It looks like we have the most, PE teachers here today, which is great because this is day one. Okay, so I'm gonna start my presentation now. So I'm gonna share my screen real quick. And let's get into day one. So like I said, day one, everybody, is a little bit more of the beginner level, not just coaches, but also for beginner level. We're gonna be going through some drills for beginner level players. Okay, so it's okay if you're a little bit more advanced, that's not a problem, okay? Because you should always be, open to learning more about, coaching younger kids, right? So here's the schedule of the day that we're gonna get into. We're gonna start with just a brief warm-up, not a physical warm-up. You don't need to get up and do any stretches or anything like that, but just kind of a thought warm-up, okay? And then we're gonna get into the program overview. So really the entire junior NBA program that we're running today. Then we're going to talk about Oklo, which is the program that all of you guys really used to register. And again, we thank you for that. Then we're going to talk about what's next. And then Coach Scott and I both have some coaching tips we're going to go through. And we'll finish off with the going through some curriculum. Okay. And it looks like I need to disable the annotation. So anybody who's drawing on the screen, please don't do that. Okay. All right. So let's get on. This is our warm-up. Exercise here. Okay, so I want you guys to think about these two questions. Okay, so finish this sentence in the chat. One of these two sentences: if you don't coach basketball, why do you want to coach basketball? I want to coach basketball because blank. If you are a basketball coach, I coach basketball because why? And please put it in the chat. I'm eager to see, why do you coach basketball? And I'll give you my example. I coach basketball because growing up, I had great coaches all throughout my life. And basketball, because of that, basketball has given me the ability to work all over the world and with all types of different people. And I want to give that back to the next generation. So that's why I coach basketball. So I want to know why you do. I see Coach Tashar coach basketball because you love basketball. That's great. And Coach Ravindir, it's your passion. I love that as well. I want to coach basketball because I love teaching basketball. That's great, Saif. Okay. Please put your answers in. I have Karthik with teach healthy lifestyle, learn to coexist with types of people, and also handles failure. That's exactly right. Wants to grow basketball in the rural area. Okay, awesome. Well, those are great answers, everybody. Thank you for putting that in. And, you know, please continue. You know, it's always good to think about why you coach, okay, which is really, you know, that's why we're here. That's why we spend all this time learning and all this time on court, is to grow the game of basketball. And I love that all of you are, you know, have a passion for this. Okay, now that we've gotten through our early kind of, you know, thought process, we do have a trivia question from Coach Scott, who's now, he's going to challenge your basketball IQ. Okay, so Coach Scott, go ahead and, and give us your question. Yeah.
So, you know, if you've been to any of the academies in the past, you know, I pull out my trivia questions, not only on NBA, but on India basketball. So here are a couple of questions I'm going to give you. If you know the answer, either raise your hand or put your emoji up there. First one, name the three teams LeBron James has played for. Three NBA teams.
Do not say it out loud. Do not. Okay, let's see. I got Manoj Singh. Manoj Singh, if you can go ahead and take yourself. Okay, there we go, my man. All right, I'm going to get you on screen share real quick. 1 second. Let me get you up. Oh, he is. Okay. Got to unmute yourself, my man.
Unmute, Manoj.
Unmute.
Oh, sorry. Good evening, coaches. Good evening, all coaches. Nice to see you. LeBron play for Cleveland Cavaliers, Miami Heat, and Lakers right now.
There you go. Good That's job, buddy. Yeah. You're an NBA fan. You must be. All right. Second question. We've got more coming later, but my second one right now. And this is more of an India basketball questions. And it even has to do with the NBA Academy. Name three former NBA Academy players that have played with the India senior national team. There's about five of them, but name three. Somebody tell me.
All right, looking around, see if anyone knows. I see Karthik Mahadevan. You need to be on camera if you're gonna try to answer. Karthik, there we go. All right, let's share. Karthik, go ahead, buddy. Take yourself off mute. Let's see if you know the answer. Don't look in the chat.
All right, you got it.
There we go.
So recently, I guess Prinsapal Singh has played, and I guess Amjot, and maybe Amritpal. I'm not sure about Amritpal, but I think I'm sure about Amjot.
All right, so you got one of them. And those are two other players I actually coached on the national team, but they didn't go to the NBA Academy. We're looking for players that were at the NBA Academy that have played for the senior national team at some point. You got one right.
Coaches, Prinsapal Singh, Aman, and Pranav Prince.
Yeah, you said Prinsapal, Aman, and who was the third one?
Pranav Prince.
There you go. All right, and the other two were Arvind Kumar and Prashant Singh, I think it's Rawat. I'm not sure how they pronounce that.
You're correct.
Yeah, so those five, and that says a lot, you know, for our academy right now, but a great answer and kind of tells you the potential of our NBA Academy players, five of them. Thanks, back to you, Brian.
All right, that's awesome. And you know what? It starts at the grassroots level, right? Getting these players to play basketball, and that's why we're here. So you see, there's a clear pathway you know, all the way up to the NBA Academy and then straight to the national team and even beyond. Okay, so nice work. I saw a lot of answers in the chat too. That's great. You guys know your stuff. Good work. Okay, I'm going to share my screen again and let's get into the objectives for day one. Okay, so any good coach that has a practice plan always has objectives for what they want to get through. Okay, so here's the objectives for day one of our Coach Academy Online. Number one, teachers and coaches will learn how to create a fun and positive environment through basketball and learn how to communicate effectively in a PE class, a basketball PE class. So that could be a basketball PE class or a basketball practice. Okay, and again, you know, nowadays when kids have so many other options, they have their phones, they have video games, we want to make sure we make basketball fun at the entry level, at the grassroots level, to make sure that they come back and keep playing. Okay. Secondly, teachers and coaches will be exposed to the junior NBA curriculum and feel empowered to run a live session. Now we're going to show later in the presentation a couple different drills for different games for different types of you know, warm up, skill building, and then gameplay. So we're going to show you some drills. We're going to talk about a couple drills, but we're also going to let you know where you can find the junior NBA curriculum and go through some of those. And again, the drills we show you, they're just one example of how to run a drill. And you know what I really love in traveling all over the world and working with coaches from different regions, especially in India, I always learn something. Okay, there's always different ways to run drills. So we're going to talk a little bit about that too. The next one is, teachers and coaches will understand the basic structure of running a basketball class. Okay, so Coach Scott is going to take us through that a little later. And lastly, we're going to go over the role of a coach, and we'll also let you guys know about the do's and don'ts of running an RF Junior NBA basketball-based PE class or basketball training session. Okay, so those are our objectives for day one. And we're going to get through all. Okay, so next thing. Upcoming events and clinics that we have. Now, all of you have registered through Oklo. Okay, so thank you again for that. That's the one spot that you can go to find out all about the RF Junior MBA program this year, okay, both virtually and on ground. Okay, so number one, we have a coaching clinic this Friday, and all of you who are already registered on the RF Junior MBA Coaches Online program, that means you already have access to this. Okay, so you just have to open Oklo on Friday at 8 o'clock, and you can watch a coaching clinic with Coach Vin Bhavnani. He's a former OKC Thunder assistant coach. He's an incredible teacher and player development coach. He's going to be focusing on player development. Okay, so that sounds very broad, but you think about it. He works with the young players and veterans on developing their game so they can then fit back into the team. Okay, and Coach Vin is very passionate about player development. And if you follow him on Instagram at Vin Bhavnani, you can see a lot of his stuff is really great. And so he's going to be, you know, spend an hour with coaches from India discussing player development. It's going to be great. So that's on Friday, March 25th at 8 p.m. Okay. And then on Friday, the following Friday, April 1st, we're going to have a coaching clinic with Coach Ron Cass, who's the player development coach at the NBA Academy. India has worked extensively with Scott. And he's going to focus on transition offense. Okay, so throughout the next few months, we're going to be having these coaching clinics on certain topics. So if you have an interest in, you know, learning more about player development or getting your team, you know, better on transition, these are types of things that will be great for you to check out. And these are also going to be, you know, chances for you to ask questions too. On Saturday, April 2nd, we're going to have our first youth clinic with Coach Ron Cass. So if any of you have players in your schools or your club teams, they can just log right on to Zoom just like this, and Coach Ron Cass will take them through a dribbling workout. Okay, and we'll make sure we get you all that information. And then again on Thursday, April 7th, we're gonna have another coaching clinic at 8 p.m. with Coach Akash Sebastian, who's a Utah Jazz assistant coach. He was born in India, spent a lot of time playing basketball at the youth level in India, and is now working as an assistant coach for the Jazz, who are one of the top teams in the West. So we're really excited to have him, and he's going to talk about basketball analytics. So basically the entry level, how to start using basketball analytics, and also video scouting. Okay, so he's going to talk about that. He's very excited to join us, and we're really excited to have him too. So I encourage you guys to check out Oklo. We'll always send out notifications when we have something new. Okay. Once again, let's get everybody on mute if we can. Okay, and secondly, another really exciting program that we have coming up this year is called our RF Junior MBA Coach Camp Online program. This is a coach accelerator program, the first time we've done this. And we're looking for the next kind of crop of great young coaches in India. So what we're looking for is engaged coaches who want to learn all across India. So we're looking for the best and the brightest. We're going to be selecting coaches from these clinics that we're running, and I'll get to how that's going to happen soon. And those coaches will be invited for advanced training. We'll bring you into a smaller group with a Zoom. We're going to bring in MBA guests, give you guys some equipment, and even spotlight you in social media. Okay, this is a way for us to grow better coaches. So again, I'll talk about how to be selected for that, but this is a really exciting opportunity. And finally, the top coaches from that program will actually be able to attend a live coaching clinic and camp at the MBA Academy in May during our RF Junior MBA National Championship and Selection Camp, okay? So here's how that's going to go. Top coaches are selected based off the following criteria. Number one, and all of you are already aced this, you must download and register for the Junior MBA, RF Junior MBA on the Oklo app. Okay, so you have to be in there. We need to see you participating. Secondly, we want to know if you're attending the clinics, you're checking out our youth clinics, you're engaged at the coach academies. Okay, so those of you who are putting answers in the chat and on camera and answering questions, that's what we're looking for. Okay, we want to see who's passionate about basketball and who's passionate about getting better as a coach. Okay. Next, we want to see video or picture submissions of students being trained using RF Junior MBA curriculum in person or virtually. Okay, and you can post that on social media and tag at MBA India and at RFU Sports. Okay, so if you see a drill that we're running that we'll show you later today or even tomorrow. Okay, go ahead and put that on social media, tag MBA India and at RFU Sports. And that's a great way to get noticed as a coach for this program. And lastly, we want to see you bring your kids to our coaching clinics, or I'm sorry, our online youth clinics. Okay, so I mentioned Coach Ron Cass has a youth clinic coming up in a couple of weeks. Okay, if you're from a certain school or a club and we see 25 of your kids on that call, that's going to reflect great on you. That means that one, you're in touch with your players. Okay, and number two, you can get that you're interested in their development. You want them to continue to get better, and that's what we're looking for. Okay, so again, that's our Coach Camp Online program. All right, now so let's move on to the next thing. So now that we know what the program is, let's get into it. Okay, we're gonna have kind of two stations. So think about this as if we're at a basketball practice and we have two hoops going at once, not at once this time, but we're going to go from one station to the next station. Okay, first Coach Scott Fleming is going to take us through the structure of a session. So Coach, if you want to start getting your presentation ready, and then after that I'm going to go through games-based coaching. Okay, so and I'll explain kind of what that means. All right, so I'm going to send it over now to Coach Scott Fleming, who's going to take on structure of a basketball session. He's sharing his screen now.
Hey, what I want to talk to you about today is just training sessions or what we'd call practice. And this may be some advanced, things, but also it'll have to do with youth coaches as well, or even PE classes. I mean, it just has to be adapted, but these are things that I think will help you. And let me say this, that as a coach, practice is my favorite part of coaching. The games are great. I look at practice as really where you learn, where you grow, and the games are the test. It's just like a player that's studying for an exam. Those are the exams. But, I love practice sessions, and I also think it's the most important part of coaching. When it comes to a game or a competition, you pretty much, there are a few things you can do to change the game, but you pretty much prepared them, and you can't get on the court. You know, some of you guys and girls were players at one point, and when you start coaching, you realize you can't make any difference at all except on the sideline. You can't get out there and play. So the time to really make the huge difference is during these training practice sessions. And so I have up there, you know, have a plan and a purpose. You know, don't just kind of throw the balls out and do what you've always done. And so let me take you to the next screen here. Okay, so, and again, some of these principles are a little more advanced, but I think that they can pertain to even youth coaching and PE classes. You know, plan your areas to cover in the preseason or prior to a tournament. So if you're coaching a club team, I mean, have a plan. And if you have like 6 weeks or 4 weeks to practice with that team and train them, you know, put down what you want to do each week. So by the time you're done with that, you know, you're ready to go with your tournament. Or if you're even teaching a PE class, so have a plan. You know, write out, if you have them for, you know, 8 weeks, you know, have a plan all the way through to make sure you're covering everything that you need to cover, not just kind of haphazard and we'll try this today and this the next day, but really plan it all out. And every season that I coached, whether it was the Indian national team or the U.S. college or in the NBA, I would take our preseason and I would map it all out and have what I was going to work on prior to that first practice. And so that's really important. When planning, keep in mind your team's weaknesses and strengths, okay? And what we say, we want to build on our strengths and we want to improve our weaknesses. And so your practice or your training sessions should show that. And again, if you're teaching a PE class and they're starting from scratch, well, and they don't know a lot of basketball, well, those are their weaknesses that you need to work on. So you need to have a plan that starts them right at the beginning. If you're coaching a pretty high level senior club team, then you need to really evaluate, you know, what your strengths and weaknesses are in helping you plan your practices. Based on your personnel, and this is maybe for more of the club teams, decide what style identity is best for your team and then design your practices accordingly. Are you going to be a fast breaking team? Are you going to be a half court team? Defensively, are you going to full court press? Are you going to just guard in the half court? And so, you know, you have to kind of decide. And again, if you're going down to the youth level, you have to decide what they're capable of doing. You know, if you you may not want to be a fast break team if they're going to throw the ball away half the time and turn it over. And so you have to decide what they're capable of doing. And then fourthly, use drills that will transfer to the game, okay? And these have, you know, you just don't want to do drills to do drills. And some of the best drills I do and some of the drills that I've seen other players do are drills that you kind of make up yourself. I mean, there is a, you know, large, and we'll talk about that more tomorrow, but you know, there is all kinds of libraries of drills and some of them are great and I use a lot of them, and every coach steals drills from another coach. That's just, you know, if you see a good one, you take it and you use it. But you want to make sure the drills you're doing are transferring to when you have a competition, whether it's at the youth level or at the highest level. You know, you don't want to do drills that really have nothing to do. And I have opinions about that, you know, probably differ from other people, but I think they need to transfer. And then have multiple drills ready. And we'll talk more about this tomorrow. And we'll talk about same skills, different drills. And so I won't say a lot about that now, but just have a good library of drills that you can use. And I'm going to give you a lot of them tomorrow and kind of talk about that. When introducing a drill, and this is really important, when introducing a drill, share with them what the drill is. First, you call it, you have to have a name for it. I think you ought to have a name for every drill, not just, hey, here's the drill where we, you know, dribble down the court and shoot. Have a name for that drill so that when you bring it up again, they know exactly what you're talking about, okay? And then this is the real important one. Tell them why you're running that drill. And you don't need to take long in doing that. And I'll talk about getting in and getting out next, but you know, tell them why. They want to know, why am I doing this drill? Am I just doing it because it's filling practice, or is it going to help me be a better ball handler? Or is it going to help our team to score more baskets inside or play better defense? So tell them why you're doing that drill. And then you get to the demonstration and you need to show them how. Don't just say do this, whether it's a, you know, today Brian will be showing you some videos on how to do a drill. But you as coaches either need to demonstrate them yourself or have some of your better players demonstrate them or assistant coaches. And then the last one is, you know, when do I use this? You need to kind of let them know what situation in the game or what time in the competition, whether it's, you know, late in the game or whether it's, you know, you've got somebody guarding you that's smaller than you. I mean, I could give you a lot of these, but you know, when to use them. So these are really important. What, you know, what, why, how, and when you're running a drill. And I'll say this, teach, but don't take too long in talking. And I say to a lot of my assistant coaches and then clinics like this, get in and get out. Shiv has probably heard this before. You want to tell them, you want to explain things, but you've been at practice, and I hope you're not this person, but I've been at practices where there's 15 minutes of talking and 5 minutes of a drill. And by not only is that wasting a lot of practice, but it's also got the players stiff. They've all stretched out and now they need to warm up again. So it's important to talk to your players and to tell them the whys and the whats and all that, but get in and get out and don't take too long with that. If you that are head coaches or that are assistant coaches, it's really important you use your assistant coaches to train. I be honest with you, I've been to some practices in India where I, from beginning to end, I only hear the head coach talking. And he runs the whole practice and the assistant coaches just kind of watch the whole thing. And for one thing, you're not helping them to grow, or you as an assistant aren't growing. The other thing is that it's not as efficient. You know, you need everybody helping to really make it more efficient. So, you know, you're a team, you're a family, you're a group that needs to help those players get better. It's not just one person. And I had to learn that as a young coach. As a young coach, I did a lot on my own, but I had to open up and let the assistants have more say. And even this one, and this is a little harder when they're young, probably, but as they grow and they become a little more knowledgeable, allow players to give input and teach other players. I think that's important to do that. And especially some of your players a little more experienced, even at the youth level, you may ask them questions or they may, you know, do you understand that, and let them maybe answer the questions that you usually would just answer. And then all drills should be done correctly and at game speed. Now, at the beginning, when you're teaching them from, you know, at PE classes, that sure, we're going to take it a little slower and give them more time. But as again, at club level, at the state level, you need to make sure that you practice correctly. You know, if you do things wrong 100 times, you're going to do them wrong in a game. You can practice as much as you want to, but if you're not doing the right thing. And then the other thing, you know, and I'll give you an example. I was at a tournament recently where this was a team playing in a national tournament, at a professional tournament. And the team came in and the coach sat down in a chair, kind of relaxed, sipping his coffee and looking at his phone while the players went half speed and they ran the practice. It was probably, to be honest with you, the worst practice I've ever seen. And it wasn't in India, it was somewhere else. And so, you know, that you just need to make sure that you prepare them the best you can and take pride in running things correctly, the right way, and correct them when they're wrong and get it right and do it at game speed. If you go half speed in practice, they're not going to be ready for the game. And then the last one, really important, correct players when needed, but celebrate their successes. I see a lot of coaches, the only communication that they do is just yelling at players and telling them every time they've done something wrong. Okay. And so it's really important to correct them and make sure you're doing that. But it, I have kind of a 5-to-1 philosophy, 5 positives to 1 correction. And they need to hear that you need to celebrate when they do it well. And they're going to be a lot more motivated to grow than after that. Any questions about any of this? I'd be happy to answer if we have enough time. Just anything that I hit on there that anybody would want to ask a question about. And I'm not seeing, I don't know if I can see the chat. Oh, here it is. Okay.
Yeah, you guys anybody can put any questions in the chat.
Yeah. Any questions? And if, you know, if we don't do that now, we'll come back to it at some point. But I'll move on. But if you have any questions, feel free to do that. Okay. All right. The next screen. You're not seeing my chat, are you?
No.
Okay. Okay. The next screen is kind of taking you through a practice schedule. All right. And you could adapt this to, you know, youth or, you know, elite players or the club level. And it's important, whatever you do, to really have a plan. And I'm going to show you even my practice sheet here next. But this is basically what I would say that a practice should look like. This would be a practice at our NBA Academy for our young guys. Okay. And now, as you get into a season, or if you get in, you know, you get closer to a tournament, or you don't have as much time, you know, this may change and you may take some elements out. But if you have 2 hours to practice, and I'm big on having about 2 hours, if you go more, I mean, I won't say I never have, but much more than 2 hours of a session, you may lose your players. It's tough for them to hang in there, you know. And I certainly have practices that are less than 2 hours at times if we have a game coming up or whatever. But this would be kind of a 2-hour practice that I'm just giving you an example of what it should look like. So you need a warm up, obviously. The worst thing in the world is just to start off a practice if nobody's warmed up and you're just asking for injuries there. And, you know, we're hoping that you do it like a dynamic stretching warm up where you're moving while you're doing it. And then we would have maybe a warm up drill or some kind of development drill. Maybe it's full court, just to kind of get them moving. It's going to transfer the game. It's something we'll use in the game, but it kind of gets them going. And then the first one was about 15 minutes. That was about 5 minutes. And then you're going to break up into doing player development. If it's only you, then you've got to do it. If you have assistant coaches, this is a great time, to split up and have stations and work on skills, you know, work on ball handling, work on shooting, the basics, the fundamentals of basketball, because you never want to go right to team play without keeping them improving in their fundamentals. And then the next one would be about 10 minutes of what we call defensive breakdown. We might be 1-on-1 or 2-on-2. Maybe you're just working on guarding the ball and keeping someone from going to the basket, working on a stance at the youth level. Just work on stance and have them improve there and have them guard someone. And then after that, 15 minutes of what we'd call team defense. So you've taken now these breakdown drills, and now you want to put it into, you know, either 3-on-3, 4-on-4, 5-on-5, and kind of work on your team defense, and whether that's zone or man. And I know Shiv's going to know this. I think that no one should ever teach a zone first. All right. And we don't teach any zone at the Academy. Just tell you that we never play any zone. Now, as a national coach, I did, you know, I ran some zone. But I always taught man-to-man. We were a man-to-man team. And I'll tell you this, if you do play zone, you're going to be a lot better zone team if you start learning man-to-man principles. And again, I see a lot of 2-3 zones out there that aren't very good. And especially at the young level, there's no reason to run zone, I don't think. It ought to be all man-to-man and teach them those principles. And then later on, if you think that's something you want to try, or you have personnel for zone, it'll make your zone that much better. Okay. And then we'll do some offensive breakdown. So we might break down running a pick and roll, or we might run, you know, driving and passing out to another player. You know, you can keep it as simple or as difficult as you want to, but you're just working. Maybe you're just working on layups, okay? Or you're working on dribble, shoot, you know, off the dribble or spot up shooting. But something that's going to work on their skills offensively. And then you take that and you put it into some team play. 3-on-3, 4-on-4, 5-on-5. And as you're developing your offense and your different things that you do, this would be the time to do that. And then most practices, then you have to simulate a game. Okay, so you've taken them through all these drills, all these things they've worked on, and now you want to play some 5-on-5 and what we call scrimmage, or just it'd be game-like. And because they need to do that in practice before you ever get to a game. And you need to try all these things you've been working on. And it'll be ugly at times. It may not be very organized, but you got to keep coming back to it and see how they do 5-on-5. And then for more advanced coaches, this wouldn't be so much for PE or youth coaches, but working on maybe some special situations. You know, you ought to be prepared for late game plays or after timeouts, and you can't just draw those up in a game. You need to be ready for those. You need to be able to call out a name. Say you got a play called Delhi that's a long pass down the court to try to score. And so make sure that you work on those. And then the last thing we try to do is maybe end practice on a positive note, whether it's just a shooting drill or, you know, some kind of competition or something, to end on a positive note. So that's kind of taking you through, you know, a normal practice session, and that'll change. There'll be elements you'll pull out, but let me, I don't know if we have anything in the chat here.
Yeah, we do, sir. We do, Scott. We have got some questions.
Okay. All right. Let's look at this. So based on your instruction, get in, get out, explain. So when I talk about get in, get out, means you want to stop practice and kind of explain to them, you know, what they're doing wrong or what they need to do. But it needs to be very short. You need to be very precise with your words and not make it a long 10-minute speech. And that's what I mean by get in, saying you're telling them what it is, and then get out and let's start playing again. All right? Are we going to get any soft copy? That's up to Brian. I'll let him answer that. Certainly put something together.
What we can do is everyone on this day one session is going to get a certificate of completion for day one and day two. So with that, we can take these slides, Scott, if that's okay with you, and sure, attach them to that email so you can have this.
Okay. Each and every time we get a lesson plan on a game. Oh, it just moved on me.
Same question. It's the same question.
Oh, okay. Okay. All right. What are the different types of styles of play the team can be modified around? So, you know, it's up to you based, again, back to your personnel. Your style might be, you're a better half court team. You don't have a real athletic team or team that can run, or you might be the opposite. Maybe, you know, some people run zones because they have, you know, slower or taller players. Again, I would just say, you know, again, work on man-to-man principles, and then if you need to run the zone. So it all depends on who your players are in determining your style, and a little bit of what you're comfortable with and what you've taught through the years and what you think's more effective. You know, I like to fast break. I like to have up-tempo teams. And so, you know, if I really felt like that wasn't the way to go, I'd change. But usually that's, you know, what I think is a better way to go. All right, let's go to the next slide here. Okay, so what you're looking at here is a blank practice sheet that I have. And I'm going to show you one that's filled in a minute. But you can see on this that it has, you know, the time, it has the name of the drill. All of my drills would have names to them. And then we'll talk about the emphasis that we want on that drill, even to remind me. But we also put these drills up before practice, and so all our players can look at that and see what's coming and kind of prepare themselves. You can see on the right there, I'm going to list all my players and then any notes that I have, and you'll see what I do with it. But on the bottom there, you see emphasis of the day. Well, I might say, some kind of, maybe it's defense, maybe pressing defense might be our emphasis of that day, or maybe we're going to work on our fast break. That would be what we work on more than anything else. A thought of the day, you know, one of the things I tell all my teams is three things they have to do is play hard, play together, and put team above self. So that might be, you know, but we have all kinds of thoughts of the day, just something. And usually I'm going to ask them when we're standing around before practice, when we gather together, you know, what's our thought of the day? I want to make sure they know that. And so that's just another way they can learn. And then any announcements we'll have for the future. So here's the next one, is just now it's filled out. Okay. And you can see I've kind of gone through like I did on that other, showing you what areas. There's our warm up. Our Argentine drill is just a full court drill that kind of gets them warmed up. Then we break into player development. And when Coach Ron was with us, and this is where you give your assistants responsibility. He ran that, you know, and I would be kind of under him during that time. He would say, Coach, you take the low post station or whatever. And so we would break our team up and just work on fundamentals and make them better players, help them to get better. We take our water breaks and we come back with breakdown offense, you know, 5-on-0 convert, and that's actually a little bit of both. And then we did our defensive breakdown, okay? And you can see there, you know, working on the basket cut, defending that, defending down screens on the ball side. And then we came back to, we took a break, and then we came back to our press break. This is our offensive breakdown. And then eventually working our way, that ODO is offense, defense, offense. So that's basically playing, but just three possessions. We start a team on offense, they get back on defense, and they come play on offense, and we keep score. We make it very competitive. So rather than just going 5-on-5 for a while, that would just be three possessions at a time. And that may be, you know, a little advanced, but you know, that may even be a way to do it with young kids, rather than just saying play and they're throwing the ball all over the place. Just, you know, cut it down into a short stint of, we're just going to play here, we're going to go down, and we're going to come back, you know, and maybe, and then you could talk to them about what you saw and make it shorter. And then we're, you know, in this session, we ended with free throws and probably some kind of free throw. In fact, it was a team free throw. So everybody lines up and everybody takes one free throw. And then we see our percentage, okay? And what I have, that 10-14, we had 14 players, we had to make 10 out of 14, or they get a little bit of extra exercise after practice if they don't make it. So that, you know, this is, again, practicing with a purpose, having a plan, writing it down, and being very precise with it. And it doesn't, you don't have to be this complex. If you're a PE teacher, but write it out, you know, whether it's four drills, and maybe you only have time for four or five drills, but have a purpose and a reason why you're doing those, but, you know, put them down and then keep track. I keep track of every sheet like this that I have way back from 20 years ago, you know, and so that I can look back at these and see what we've already done. Okay. That kind of closes out my session. Let's see if we have any questions.
Yeah, we do have a few questions.
Okay. How should we assess player before starting a coaching session? So, you know, there are ways to do that. Just, you know, even starting with some basic drills, you know, you'll find out about some of your players running a layup line. And then you could do some kind of shooting drill. And a lot of times we evaluate players too. Like when we come and evaluate players for the academy, what we're probably going to do is do some station drills and see how their skills are. Maybe with shooting, you know, with ball handling, we're going to have some kind of ball handling station. We would have some kind of defensive station. So after we've done that, then I really like 3-on-3 because you can't hide in 3-on-3. And 5-on-5, you can kind of hide if they don't throw you the ball, or if you don't get it, you know, it's hard to know. But you know, we would usually do some 3-on-3, and in 3-on-3, you know, you're going to find out what kind of player they are usually. And so I would say do some skill stations, or if you don't have stations, if it's just you, just work on some, you know, some drills that are skill based. And then if you can do 3-on-3, that's a great way to find out kind of where they're at.
Okay.
All right. Why do we have to give so many breaks in a short practice plan? Well, because, you know, it's not safe always to just keep practicing somebody. They have to have water, they have to have some breaks, and that's a physiological thing that, you know, if it was up to me, I'd probably keep going, but I know the body can't do that. And so it's important to give breaks. And one thing we do in our breaks usually is I give them 2 minutes to get water, and then they've got to be on the free throw line or they've got to be doing something during that break. So it's not just standing around too. Let's see. Children try to go from their focus. How to give game practice, especially speed workout, if the school doesn't have a basketball court. Hey, that I know, and you know, I've been in India for a good 5 years, and I've seen situations like this. I know we had a school down in Kerala that I remember. They had a pretty great basketball program. They didn't have any baskets. They had a flat cement pad, but they would work on everything they could besides that. And then one day a week, they would try to reserve a practice court somewhere where they could shoot. And I know that's not the best, but you know, there's good, better, best, and they were doing a good thing down there. And so, you know, there are things you can do besides shooting, but you know, with the shooting part of it, you might have to transport your players somewhere. And I don't know how easy that is, but that's the reality of it. How many students per session per coach would be ideal? You put under 12, 13. So I think how many students, I mean, 12 is ideal. Because you want to have at least 10, but if you have more than that, you know, there's ways to work them in. We've had up to 24 players at the academy, and sometimes it's being on two courts at one time, and that's where you let your assistants or somebody else helping you to do that. But smaller numbers are better if they're all, I say 12 because you're always going to have somebody, or a lot of times somebody hurt, somebody can't make it or whatever. So, you know, when you hit that 9 place, then your assistant coaches have to play, right, Shiv? So you have to throw them in there when you don't have to.
Always.
So if you don't want to have to play, you need to make sure you've got at least 10 if you're going to play 5-on-5. All right, so I think I probably got, for time's sake, I ought to move on here probably, Brian, but I hope that this helped somewhat. I think it, you know, it can relate to the youth level as well as advanced level. And I think my main theme is, you know, have a plan, have a purpose, and be organized about it, and demand that they do the same things in practice that they would do in the game. You know, I've said this many times, I don't know how a coach can yell at a player and be mad at a player in a game when he makes a mistake at something you've never worked on in practice. Does that make sense? So, practice is where you become a great coach. It's not the game. Everybody thinks you know, the game's where you make all your moves, but mostly I'd say 90% of it is how you practice. All right? Okay.
Awesome, thank you, coach. And like I said earlier, everybody, we'll go ahead and send out some soft copies of this, so we'll get the practice plan and the points that Coach Scott had mentioned over to you all. Okay, so I'm gonna share my screen now, and we're gonna get into the next station here, and I'm gonna be showing some videos of girls here. So this is gonna be based off games-based coaching. Okay, so that's our next kind of station here, and. What is games-based coaching? A games-based approach to coaching basketball means using fun and or competitive games to get kids moving while teaching and learning fundamental skills, okay? So this could have two different meanings, really. One, games-based can mean fun games, like a tag game, using a tag game as a warm-up. You know, and that's gonna work for younger players, you know, for PE sessions, just kids just getting started playing basketball. That's a games-based approach. So rather than having, you know, 7-year-olds run 7 laps to warm up, why don't you have them, you know, play tag? So they're having fun and warming up at the same time. It also means competitive games. So, you know, 3-on-3, like Coach said, or even 2-on-1, you know, where advantage and disadvantage games. One thing we'll talk about tomorrow is small-sided games, and that's another kind of part of a games-based approach to basketball. And there's a couple key questions that coaches can ask themselves just to figure out, you know, how much of a games-based drill should I run or practice should I run. Number one, what ages and skill levels am I coaching? You know, for example, if you're going into a very entry level PE class, you know, with, you know, 10 9-year-olds, and they've maybe never played basketball before, maybe a few of them have, you're probably not going to run, you know, an advanced offense right away, right? So in that sense, maybe it's better to make sure they're having fun, they're moving, they're learning the fundamental skills of basketball through games. And secondly, can I make drills more engaging and fun by turning them into a game or adding a competitive element? And we'll talk a little bit about that. I'll show you some examples and we can talk about how we can turn them into games or competitions. And there's one thing that Scott mentioned in his presentation a little earlier, how he said, you know, a lot of the drills they do in a certain portion of practice are competitive, right? So that's just having, you know, not just running a drill, but making sure there's a winner and a loser, right? And that kind of builds competitiveness in your team, and it's also more game-like. Okay, so in this next segment, I'm going to show a video, and don't play the video yet, please. But I want you guys to watch this first drill, okay, very closely, and this is where I want you guys to be very engaged. Okay, so I want you to watch this drill. We're going to play this drill, and I want you to put in the chat your thoughts on the drill. Number one, what was the point of the drill in the game? Or the game. Number two, what did you notice about the kids when we're going to play this drill? And number three, what did you notice about the coach? Okay, so let's go ahead and play that video. Video number one.
This is the toss and catch drill. It's a great drill for youth players to get comfortable with the basketball. All right, guys, we're going to circle up here. We're all gonna do this together as a team, all right? So when I say toss, we're gonna toss the ball up in the air, catch it with two hands. We're gonna hold it until I say to do it again. Does everybody understand? Everybody understand? Louder. Everybody understand? Okay, ready. One, two, three, toss, catch. Good, all right? Now, oh, we didn't do it. Come back. Everybody's gotta do it. Everybody on the team has to do it to advance. One, two, three. All right, we did it. Success, all right? So now, the next one, we're going to toss it, and we're going to add a clap now. So we toss it, we clap once, and catch it. All right? Everybody has to do it to move on. One, two, three. Two hands. Oh, almost. All right, let's try it again. One, two, three. Yes, success. All right? Now, we're going to go to two claps. Two claps. Toss and two claps. Hold the ball. Ready? One, two, three. Almost, almost, almost. All right, let's try again. Try again. Try again. One, two, three. Great job. All right, we did it. You want to go to three? You think we can do three? Can we do three? One, two, three. Two hands, we did it. Yes. All right, now I'm going to throw something else in. Okay, this time there are no claps, but when I throw it up, I have to turn around and catch it. All right? We're going to turn around and catch it, all right? On the count of three. Remember, we want to throw the ball straight up. Throw it straight up, all right? One, two, three. Oh, almost. And that's the toss and catch drill, a great fundamental skill for all kids. And remember, feel free to add some variety to the drill.
Okay, so that's just a pretty simple, very basic drill, okay, that could be run in a PE session or even a first basketball practice for younger kids. So I want to ask question number one, okay, and put this in the chat. What was the point of the drill for the game? What's the point? Okay, so let's see what we have in the chat. We've got Rahul Sarkar. Rahul, can we get Rahul Sarkar spotlighted? I liked his answer there. Let's get Rahul Sarkar. Go ahead and take yourself off mute, Rahul. If we can get him, let me see if I can get him on screen real quick. Rahul, if you can start your video, we can get you on. But you said working on motor skills, I believe. Okay. And Simpal said balance the ball along with eye-hand coordination. Exactly. Those are, that's why we're doing the drill, right? Now, there's other ways you could do that for young kids, but that was a fun game that still worked on basic ball handling skills. Okay. Now, secondly, what did you guys all, and guys and girls, all notice about the kids in the drill? What did you notice with that? A few things that you saw about the kids. Okay, Coach Mark. Let's get Coach Mark on the screen. Coach Mark Salo. Can we get Coach Mark Salo on the screen, please? If he's got his camera on, I'll do it. Okay, there's Mark. Okay, Coach Mark, you take yourself off mute. Coach, you got to take yourself off mute, my friends. I still can't hear you, but that's okay. You said they were engaged, okay? Maybe put it in your the chat, you know, what part of India you're from. We'd love to know about that. But they said, yeah, the kids were engaged. They're having fun. They're smiling, okay? Sachin Kumar says they're having fun and focused, okay? The coach kept throwing different things at them, and they were laughing, and they were even dropping the ball, right? A couple kids dropped the ball, and instead of being discouraged, they laughed about it, right? You're gonna fail. Kids are gonna fail when they play, okay? So it's okay. And that's an example of using a games-based approach, okay? So the coach, you know, that was my next question. What did you answer about the, or what did you notice about the coach? Okay, he was positive. He was giving confidence, right? He's saying, good job. He was having fun. Okay, he turned it into a game. He said, I've got one more challenge for you. Let's try three claps now. Okay, now let's try to spin around and catch. Okay, again, you're not going to do that in a game. You're not going to spin around a game. But this is more for the younger players, right? This is making sure they're fun or they're having fun and being engaged. Okay, so that's a very, very, very basic drill. But it's, you know, what I want you to take away from this is you can turn a basic ball handling warm-up game, a drill, into a game to make it more engaging and fun. Okay? Now, I'm going to show another drill here. And actually, you know what? I think in the interest of time, we have to move on to our curriculum. Okay, so we're going to get back into that. But I do just want to mention one more thing about games-based coaching. I want all of you to think about the basic drills you do for either in even a PE class or at the younger age of a basketball practice session, and think about how you can make it more fun and more game-like. Okay, so that's a challenge I have for all you coaches out there moving forward. With younger, less experienced coaches, our kids. Okay, so before we get into our curriculum, we're going to go through some curriculum drills for warm-up, skill building, and competition. I do want to challenge your basketball IQ one more time. So I'm going to throw it over to Coach Scott, who's got another trivia question, and be ready to answer. So go ahead, Coach Scott.
All right, here we go. This is the third one. What NBA team did Prince Paul Singh play for in the 2021 NBA Summer League? What NBA team? It was just this past summer. Who knows?
All right. Saif was the first one. So go ahead and take yourself off chat. Don't put it, or take yourself off mute. Saif, what do you got?
Sacramento Kings.
You are right. Good job. Good job, Saif. Okay. Second one. This round, name the player on the Milwaukee Bucks that visited India and hosted our junior NBA team at his house in Orlando, Florida. Who knows?
Let's see. Let's stump them here. Let's see. Rajdeep. I see Rajdeep on camera. Thank you, Rajdeep.
So, Robin Lopez.
Oh, he's close. He's close. Somebody else.
Sorry. Brook Lopez.
Okay. Yeah. We'll give it to him. He had the last name right. So yeah, yeah. The twin Brooke brothers. Right?
That's right.
Brooke. No, Robin was in India, but Brooke was the one that hosted the team in Orlando. Great job.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Nice job. So far, so good. Thank you, Rajdeep. Appreciate that. Rajdeep, where are you from? What part of India are you in? You can take yourself off mute.
Yeah, I'm from West Bengal, and I started a small academy for teaching new students so small kids to teach the basketballs. I'm giving classes in my club also, a little bit time, and some private coachings too.
Awesome. Well, thank you. Thank you for joining. And thanks for thanks for being a coach. Appreciate it. All right, so let's get into the next part. And again, this next part of the presentation is going to be very interactive. But we're going to go right into the Reliance Foundation Junior MBA curriculum and kind of how it's set up. Okay, and you can find this curriculum at juniormba.com. Okay, it has all practice plans and videos. And some of the drills may work for, you know, your players, some may not, right? Not every drill is going to always work for you or your players, but what you can think about is how to adapt drills, okay? And the curriculum is kind of is broken down into three parts, and we're going to show some videos from each of the three parts. Number one is fit. That's a warm-up, okay? Warm-up activities and games to get kids moving. Second is learn. That's building skills and introducing team concepts. And lastly, play. So that's competitive, small-sided games, you know, scrimmages. Okay, so I've got a couple different drills I wanna show. And we're gonna start, I'm gonna stop sharing my screen here. We're gonna start with a warm-up drill called the escape game.
This is the escape game. We're gonna learn how to warm our bodies up and in a way that's athletic and fun and get everybody going ready for practice. So check it out, everybody. You're gonna get with a partner, okay? Find a partner. And with that partner, you're gonna be, figure out who's gonna be number one and number two, okay? All right, figure it out. So now, the first one we're gonna do is we're gonna do 2 feet together hops. We're gonna be hopping across the court with your partner. One partner's gonna close their eyes. So right now, partner number one, close your eyes. Okay? Partner number two, you are going to, when I say go, you're going to hop away from them on 2 feet. Partner one, number one, when I say open your eyes, you're going to find them and hop to them and tag them. The boundaries for the drill is gonna be the baseline and the sidelines, the whole basketball court, okay? So on my go, partner number one, close your eyes. Okay, partner number two, start hopping away. Here we go, good. Number one, turn, find, and hop and tag your partner. Work to find your partner, there you go. Warm up your body. Yeah, try to tag them, hop. You wanna hop on two, freeze. Who tagged their partner? Okay. All right, bring it back in, back into the middle, hustle up, back into the middle. All right, so. Same thing, we're gonna switch it up. Partner number two, you're gonna close your eyes. You ready? Partner number one, start hopping away. Two, open your eyes, hop to find your partner. Here we go, go get him, go find him. Big hops, tag him. Come on, tag him, freeze. Did everybody tag somebody? Who tagged somebody? All these two fell out. All right, okay, bring it in, bring it in, bring it back in. Next one, next one, next one. Now we're going to skip to find our partner.
I put a couple questions in the chat and I want to hear from you, okay? Number one, everyone kind of has that basic sense of that drill, right? It's a basic warm up for younger, inexperienced players, okay? So we're getting them moving, they have partners, and then they have to do a certain movement to try to tag their partner, okay? So what are some things that we could add to that drill to work on, you know, or even, you know, other exercises. Anyone else? I see Sonal says it's a warm up with fun, exactly. Oh, okay, Arpon Campbell says with a basketball. Okay, that's a great point. You can actually have players dribbling a basketball or only have one of the partners. So now we're making just a general warm up, also a dribbling drill, right? So that's a great one. What about other exercises, okay? So some other maybe dynamic exercises. You saw they were doing a hop, okay? Which gets kids warmed up. What about, what else? I see Sachin says we can use cones also. So maybe players have to run or do a certain movement to a cone. That's another good way. Okay, Karthik says jumping jacks, right? You could do jumping jacks. So instead of just having all the kids stand there and do regular jumping jacks, make it a game, right? Make this a game where they have to get away from attack. Okay, lateral movements. defensive slides even. Okay, so those are great examples of adjusting a basic drill and making it into a game. Okay, awesome. So let's get move on to the next drill real quick. This one's called freeze tag.
At the end of the day, basketball is a fun sport. So I think it's key to include things in the warm-up that make it fun to prepare for this game. One of the things that we can include is a game called freeze tag. Great way to warm up, increase your core temperature, get the blood flowing, but also a fun way to prepare. So we're gonna have somebody that's it. And that person can go around and tag the other people on the team. What we're gonna do is we're gonna stay within the three-point line and we're gonna have somebody be it and tag as many people as possible. In this game, once you tag everybody, the game would be over, okay? So, Olivia, you're gonna be it, all right? You guys are gonna run around and try to avoid her tag, okay? Why don't you guys spread out? Stay inside the three-point line. Everybody ready? Go! That's it, that's it. Move around, move around, move around. Stay frozen, you gotta stay frozen, you gotta stay frozen. Oh, frozen. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Keep running, keep running, keep running. That's it, keep going, keep going. Come on, sprint, sprint, sprint. Cheer him on, guys, cheer him on. And freeze, and relax. Great job, guys, great job. So as you guys can see, it's a great way, a fun drill that you can include at the end of the warm-up to get them ready to play.
Okay, so that's a drill or a game called freeze tag. Okay, and you see a lot of quick lateral movements where, you know, I see a lot of that type of movement in the basketball game, right? So that's a great warm up. Now, a lot of these answers are going to be the same as the last drill, but what could we add? What could we add to that drill to maybe add another skill? Ravinder Singh says a dribble, right? We could, exactly. You can give them a basketball, right? Give maybe everybody a basketball or only the non-taggers a basketball. Okay, that's a great way to, again, work on ball handling. Now, as you're trying to avoid getting tagged, you might have to do a crossover between the legs or behind the back to get away from the tagger. Okay? Only slides, says Mark Sabo. That's right. Yep, maybe they can only defensive slide. Okay, working on that lateral movement and not crossing your legs. One leg hop. That's right. What's a way we can make this competitive? Is there any way we can make this type of drill competitive? Anyone know? Very curious to see if anyone can think of a way to make freeze tag competitive. A time limit, that's right, Karthik, exactly. That's putting limits like a time limit is a great way to make it competitive. So one thing that I've done and I've seen coaches do before with freeze tag is they'll say, okay, team one, you have to try to tag all of team two and I'm gonna time how long it takes you. Okay, so then you go, maybe they get 30 seconds, they tag everybody. Okay, now we switch. Now team two has to tag team one. And we're gonna see if they can get it faster, okay? Now, that's just a small little competition, but you're putting a time limit on it and you're making them competitive while also warming up. Okay, so thank you to everyone. One versus two, sister it, that's great. Going between the legs, exactly. So these are all good ways to modify this drill and keep it fun. Okay, so that's warm up. We're just gonna show you two drills per part, okay? So that was our warm up. Now let's get into teaching skills and building skills. So let's get to the next drill. And this is, again, this is a little more learning. So this fits into our learn portion of practice.
This is the catch with coach drill. Now, we can put a lot of offensive fundamentals into this, but this is perfect because it gives us the opportunities to show our hands as a receiver for the passer to be able to give a strong chest pass, thumbs down, stepping into it, and they understand that coming off the dribble, they have instinctual pass and catch with the coach. One, two, three, triple threat. Good, dribble with your right hand, dribble with your right hand. Good. Ball. Good, chest pass through. Nice, we wanna always keep our dribble, keep our eyes up, and we're ready to pass at our teammates at all times. Ball, good, she gave a great pass. Stepped into it, thumbs down. Ball, good, nice job. Keep dribbling. Good, we always got our eyes looking up as we're doing it. We wanna be able to catch it. Ball, good, I'm showing my hands that I'm being able to pass it back to them. stepping, thumbs down, able to receive. Ball, nice. We're gonna keep going with that same dribble, same dribble, same dribble. Ball, good. Basketball stance. And that's Catch with Coach.
All right, so this is another good drill that's working on what? What are the two things we're working on there? I mean, it's pretty obvious, right? Passing and dribbling, right? So are there any ways we could make this a little bit more of a games-based drill rather than, you know, just stationary passing and dribbling? How can we make this more games-based? Anyone know? This is a little bit more of a tough one. How can we turn this into more of a game? Rahul says, add some movement through cones. Okay. There we go, Sam. Great point. It could be done with a partner, okay? And we could see which partner group can get the most passes in a set time limit, okay? Exactly. All right, so dribbling same time to, oh, there we go. Yeah, Samad says, like you said, sent that to it in a direct message, but you can dribble and at the same time, you're trying to steal other players' basketballs while also making a pass to the coach when they call on you. That's a great way to do it, okay? Nice, very good. We can add two basketballs, okay? If players are dribbling two basketballs, then maybe they have to pass with one hand, okay? So now we're working on those one-hand passes, okay? Very good. Okay, so in the interest of time, guys, we gotta move on to the next drill. So let's get to block-to-block shooting. It's our second learn drill.
And this is our block-to-block shooting drill. The whole point of this drill is that we're gonna go for accuracy. We're gonna make sure our follow-through is in place. We're aiming for our target, which in this case will be the square on the backboard. We're gonna shoot up, come back down. Once we get it up, the shooter is not gonna worry about rebounding the ball because he's got his partner here that's gonna help him rebound. He's gonna sprint across to the other block, be able to catch it, same formation, shoot, out on the target, which again is the square on the backboard. We want to go for accuracy. You ready, shooter? Here we go. Good. We got the rebounder. He's ready. He's got a great follow through. He's actually getting to his spot pretty quickly. All you want to do is get to your spot and shoot. That's a great job, you two. Next pair, come on, let's go. That's an awesome job. Here we go. We got our shooter ready. She's got her eye on the target. Going up to the block. We got a rebounder here. Soft pass. Good, good. Make sure we hold our follow through. We want our follow through the whole entire time. We're going for accuracy and precision. That's a great job. Can I get two more people? Great job, team. All right, we're gonna take our time. Take our time. All right, we're going for accuracy. Get on the square. Good. We got our rebounder right there ready for him. Nice. Good. Notice how he immediately gets his eye on the target, gets a great shot, gets it high up on the glass, and he finishes. And that's block-to-block shooting.
Basic shooting drill. Okay, we're working on, obviously, we're working on shooting. Why is that a good drill for younger players? I'd like to hear in the chat if you know. Why is that a good drill for younger players? I mean, even older players, but specifically for maybe beginners. Who don't have a lot of experience shooting or aren't great shooters. Positioning close to the basket. That's right, Rohit. That's a great answer. Players are closer to the basket. They don't have to, you know, they can work more on actually making a shot, right? And you saw the coach in that video mentioned, you know, aim for the square in the backboard. So just confidence-wise, it's always great for kids to see shots go in, right? And if they're shooting from too far away, they're probably not going to make that. So you always want to start a little closer to the rim for younger players, okay? Now, we were only using one hoop and there's only four players on that particular drill. If you have a lot more than that, what else could we do? Let's say you have, you know, 20 players. It's probably not a good idea to just go two at a time, right? How else could we arrange the drill to maximize time and space? If you have more than one hoop, what could you do? Okay, lines. Anything else? Okay, what if you had two teams shooting at either side of the court, and it was we made it a competition. Let's see who can make the most in a minute. Okay, Sam says four teams, exactly. Manoj, competition, exactly. Okay, you can turn that into a competition. And it doesn't have to be a competition between the two teams, right? You could say, hey guys, yesterday, me and my buddy, we made 20 shots in a minute. Let's see if you can beat that. Okay, they're a team, they're trying to beat you guys, or you, right? So it doesn't have to be competition within the team. You can give them a number. And even then, the next day, you say, okay, yesterday we made 10 shots. Now, can we beat 10? Okay, now they're playing under a time limit, right? Which is very similar to a game, okay? All right, we only have one more drill. So we're gonna skip the up or down game. We're gonna get into one of my favorites. I call this numbers game. And this is part of our play portion of the practice, okay? So this is more of a gameplay based, what you might end your practice on, okay? So let's go ahead and play 2-on-2 numbers game.
All right, this is the 2-on-2 numbers game. It's a great competitive game for kids to interact with a teammate, working on passing and cutting, setting screens and moving. First thing I'll do is assign each kid a number group. All right, you guys are both the number one. You guys are teammates, one. You guys are teammates, number two. Teammates, number three. Teammates, number four. All right, what number?
One.
What number?
Two.
What number?
Three.
What number? What number?
Four.
Yeah, that's right, good, all right. So I'm gonna call out a number, throw the ball out. The first two teams to get it, we'll play 2-on-2. All right, we got it?
Six.
We got it? Okay. 2 and 4, 2 and 4. Good, match up, good. Good, you guys gotta match up. Good screen, nice screen, good shot. Great job. Great screen, great shot on the baseline. Here we go. 1 and 3, 1 and 3. Match up, good. Help. Good pass, good move. Oh, traveling, baseline. Good move, here we go. 3 and 2, 3 and 2, 3 and 2. Good move, nice. Gotta finish that, good move. Good rebound, good job, here we go. 1 and 4, 1 and 4, 1 and 4. Good hustle, guys, good hustle. There you go. Good job with the left. Let's go. Let's work on defense. Here we go. 1 and 3, 1 and 3, 1 and 3. Good pass. Match up defense. Good shot. One shot only. Good job. It's all right. Good shot on the baseline. 2 and 3, 2 and 3, 2 and 3. Good. Good cut. Pass and cut. Good cut. Good screen. It's all right. Great shot. Here we go. Good shot. 1 and 3, 1 and 3. Good move, good help, good pass. Good move. Foul. All right, let's go on the baseline. Good job. Okay. That is the 2-on-2 numbers game. As coaches, we really want to emphasize passing and cutting and screening on the ball.
Okay, so like Coach was saying there, that's 2-on-2 numbers game, okay? It's a great drill, and you saw that. It's fast moving, okay? It's a small-sided game, which we'll talk more about tomorrow during our more advanced session, okay? But this is a drill that you can kind of adjust however you want it, okay? They were playing there in half court, okay? But you could also play full court, you know, and you could add 3-on-3 or 4-on-4. Okay, but playing 2-on-2 is a great way. I think Coach Scott said 3-on-3 can't hide in 3-on-3, right? But at the same time, players are going to get more of an opportunity to touch the ball in even 2-on-2 or 3-on-3. Now, a lot of times, I'm sure that 2-on-2 style, you know, those little kids looked familiar to a lot of us, right? There's a lot of travels, a lot of mistakes, okay, a lot of double dribbles. What I notice sometimes in a 2-on-2 style game is a player will dribble and then pick the ball up, right, and get into trouble. So what can we do to help with that? I want to see if anybody has a particular answer. What can we do to help a player who always dribbles and gets stuck and picks the ball up? I'll tell you, and it's something that I do a lot. You let the coach be an outlet, okay? So the coach, Shivam or Sukanta, I see you watching, okay? If you're the coach of a two-on-two numbers game, right, you can go be the outlet. So they can pass to you and you'll pass right back to them, okay? So that way they can work on not just dribbling, picking the ball up, but pass the ball to the coach, okay? Because maybe their other player isn't open. Or, you know, a lot of times, you know, players don't yet know how to move without the ball, okay? But if the coach can be the outlet, that's going to help keep the game going, okay? Now, again, you can modify this drill to be two-on-two, two-on-three. You can focus on making it be, you know, you have to only have three passes, or you have to have a minimum of three passes before you can even get a shot. Okay, that's another way. But this, any sort of numbers game style, it's a good small-sided game to end a practice with younger players. Okay, because a lot of times what you may see is a five-on-five full-court game is going to look pretty crazy. Okay, so maybe build up to that rather than just throwing them right into a five-on-five. Okay, and also to go to Coach Sunal, who had that point about, you know, limited space. If you only have a half court, you can do more of a two-on-two, okay? All right, so that's it. I know we're running out of time here. I don't want to keep everybody, and I know it's late night, but those are just some drills at the beginner level that I wanted to take you all through, and I really appreciate everybody, you know, putting their thoughts into the chat. That's the best way, really, to think about and develop as a coach, okay? So I'm going to share my screen one more time, 1 second here. And once again, you can find all those drills and many more on JuniorMBA.com. Okay, we have a full curriculum with videos and practice plans. And that's it for the day, everybody. Now remember, tomorrow is going to be day two of the Coach Academy. That's tomorrow, same time, and it's going to be a little more advanced. Okay, so we're looking for more team-based coaching tips. Okay, so we're going to be working on more small-sided games, okay, using different types of small-sided games. And then Coach Scott is also going to talk about loading and deloading drills and games. So adding things to drills that make them harder or easier. Okay, adding limitations for players. It's a great way to develop new skills and more skills with one drill, okay? So that's day two. We hope to see everybody there. And again, thank you to all of you who put your thoughts in the chat and who were, you know, had yourself on camera and were willing to ask questions. Really appreciate it. Again, I just want to say this last piece. You know, all of you are the most important part of the Reliance Foundation Junior MBA program. Without coaches, we can't grow the game. Okay, so it means a lot for all of you to show up today and listen and learn. And again, we can learn from you also. Okay, but we want to give everybody a chance to play basketball. That's our goal, right? And you guys are the ones who are going to be helping out with that. Okay, so again, make sure you get on Oklo. Everything we run will be on Oklo, so you can check it out. Everyone that attended today will receive an email with their part one certificate in the coming days, as well as the the soft coaching plans that Coach Scott mentioned. Okay, Coach Scott, anything before we get out?
No, just great to see over 130 of them here, and I love the input they had, and love seeing all the ones I know, and great to meet new people. So, hey, look forward to tomorrow.
Absolutely. Okay, I hope to see everybody there tomorrow. Even if you're a beginner coach, I still recommend, you know, you get on tomorrow and you can learn some new things, you know, even if it's a little bit more advanced, but that's okay. Okay? Thank you, everybody. I hope to see you on the court soon. And we'll talk to you tomorrow. Thank you.